Hey guys, what's up? I'm Brian Lovett, aka B-Love. Today we're going to talk a little bit more about the COVID masks for the coronavirus and how we can get more of these into the hands of hospital workers, doctors and nurses, those on the front line. Let's get into it. Now, the mask I've been talking about the most is this one. This is the one that I've printed about 50 of and are actually in the hands of hospital workers. We've talked about it before. It has the TPU outer layers. It has the PETG main portion of the mask. And it's a pretty decent design. The one drawback to this is that it has a very small cross-sectional filter area. And because of this, it's very difficult to breathe in after long periods of time. So as you can see, we're using my paper towel example, but you cut that out and you pop it in here. And once you've got this in place, which is difficult to do backwards, by the way, once you snap it in and you get it seated, it looks like that. You've got a nice solid filter there and you pop the cover on, you're good to go. There's been talk of people using H600 filter material. The filter material is actually what they use to set instruments on in the ER, in the surgery areas for patients. They have an abundance of this material in the hospitals, and so it's really easy for them to use. Now, if you're trying to procure some of that H600 material, it's actually really expensive. It does filter things very, very well, so it's a great alternative for hospitals to use instead of N95 masks, but you're probably not going to be able to get it on your own, at least not inexpensively. So if this mask is hard to breathe in, and the idea here is that we want to make these comfortable for hospital workers, we want to get them using them on long shifts that are 8 to 12 hours, what's next? Well, you probably saw me wearing this one in my last video, and if you didn't see that video, check out the coronavirus playlist. I've got details about all the different iterations we've gone through to make these masks and get them into people's hands. The thing I love about this mask is that it has this huge cross-sectional area for the filter. Now, it does make it a little bit odd because the hospitals or the staff would have to cut a slightly awkward piece of filter material in order to do this, but I think that the airflow benefits and the breathability and usability, wearability of this probably outweigh that issue. Now, the problem I had with this mask is that it prints out in two separate pieces. So you have this TPU layer and you have this PETG layer, and you have to figure out a way to bond them together. I used super glue and it still just kind of came apart. So I took this design and I used Fusion 360 from Autodesk to merge the two meshes together, the mesh from this and the mesh from this. And what I came up with was this mask. So it's one solid piece, and the difference is when I import it into Slicer, I set a layer height change so that the first 50-60% prints in PETG, as we usually do, and then the rest of the mask prints in super flexible TPU. The beautiful part of this is now this thing is extremely solid. These two pieces don't have any adhesion problems, they're not going to come apart, and there isn't going to be any really big micro fissure or areas where the virus could potentially get in or air could get in and out, which is of course what we want here. So I'm going to share this file. This was not my original design. I've just remixed it and made it, I think, better for this purpose. Now, I've had so many questions recently that what I did is I started a Slack channel called maskforhospitals.slack.com. So I'm going to drop a link in the description with an invite to that Slack channel. There's already 50 or 60 people on there, and I would love for you to come in there, ask your questions, grab the files. I'm sharing all my 3MF files, as is everybody else that's part of the community. We're all getting feedback from doctors and hospitals, and we're sharing that feedback with each other to try and improve these and make these better. And we even have hospital workers in the Slack channel giving us feedback in real time. Now, a number of you are new to 3D printing, and that's fantastic. That's not a problem. We're here to help. So again, jump in the Slack channel and we'll help you along the way if you have any questions. But some things that have come up already are, well, what's a 3MF file and how do I import that for my Creality or my Ender, like whatever printer you have. And the fact is you can import it into Prusa Slicer, which can be used for a number of different 3D printers. Once you've imported it into Prusa Slicer, you can export it as G-code, you can export an STL file, but the beautiful part of me giving you a 3MF file is that it has all of the settings for infill, perimeters, the layer changes, everything else already baked in, so you don't have to worry about doing any of that yourself. You can just tweak it a little bit here and there based on your printer's behavior and settings, and you're kind of off to the races. The other cool thing is other people are sharing their 3MF files. So if somebody comes up with a better way to print these than I do, then I'm gonna get that from them and they're gonna share that with the community, which is the entire purpose of this. Finally, lots of you wanna get involved and you may not have a 3D printer, so you've been asking me, what's a good 3D printer to get started with? Now, of course, I love Prusa. I've been using it for a long time. The thing is a workhorse. I have the Prusa Mark IIIs. Now, some people are trying to get involved in the hobby and they might wanna just do it to print the 3D masks. And they want to get in at a lower price point. One that seems really popular that a number of people in the community use is the Creality Ender 3. The Creality Ender 3 costs quite a bit less than the Prusa Mark IIIs. It still does really high quality prints and it's compatible with Prusa Slicer and a lot of the other software that we're all using to share files back and forth. So if you're looking for a way to get involved in this, and you want to get involved a little bit less expensive, that's probably a good option for you. So that's it. Sorry for the barrage of updates. I know it's been a lot of videos in a very short period of time. Check my coronavirus playlist for all of the videos in the series. I walk you through every iteration we've gone through with the masks and where we're at today. And again, hit up the Slack channel, leave me some comments, and let me know how you want to get involved. We're here to help out. Thanks, guys. See you next time.